Hey, Andy Chamberlain, and today we're going to talk about church modes. So, real quick, going into this, you should know what a major scale is and what a key signature is. If you don't know what those things are, this is probably a little advanced. So, the goals for this video are that by the end you will understand what modes are, what the church modes are, and where the church modes come from. So I'm going to try to be as concise as possible. Alright, let's get into this. What is a mode? We'll start with that. This is a definition which I think is fairly easy to understand, but will also take you a long way in terms of being, quote-unquote, technically correct. Okay? And that is, the mode of a scale is defined by the specific sequence of intervals between scale degrees. So, what is the interval from scale degree 1 to scale degree 2? What is it from 2 to 3, from 3 to 4, etc., all the way up the scale? That sequence of intervals is what a mode is. A scale degree, by the way, if I have a scale like this, the scale degrees are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc., right? Now, the church modes actually only contain half steps and whole steps. Those are the only intervals they contain. So, for the context of this video, a mode is the specific sequence of half and whole steps going up the scale. Now, church modes. Let's get into it. There are 7 church modes, and they're called church modes for the reason you probably expect. They were the scales used in the medieval church. Anyway, so we're going to look at this stuff from the perspective of C major. Okay, so this is the C major scale, right? But there's a more specific name for it, which is the church mode name, Ionian. Okay, so Ionian denotes that exact sequence of half steps and whole steps. Root, whole, whole, half, whole, whole, half. That is Ionian. Okay? Now, we'll look at the rest of the modes, as I said, from the perspective of C major. So, if we go up a C major scale, but play a scale on each of the notes, you'll see what I mean in a second, we get this. So we start with C Ionian, and then D Dorian, okay? This is the Dorian mode. Okay, E Phrygian, F Lydian, G Mixolydian, A Aeolian, this is the common minor mode, B Locrian, and then we're back to C Ionian, right? So those are the church modes. They don't have to be in those specific places, though. That was just an easy way to kind of visualize and pump out the modes. You can certainly have D Dorian, but you could just as easily have F Dorian, etc., right? Okay, so we'll just the order once more is this. Ionian, Dorian, Phrygian, Lydian, Mixolydian, Aeolian, Locrian, and then back to Ionian, okay? So let's say that we want to use one of these church modes, but not with the all-natural key, starting somewhere else, okay? Let's say we want to play G-sharp Phrygian. Okay, so what we can do is we can look back at the original C major-based thing and see that the Phrygian scale is this one. Okay, if you take that sequence of whole and half steps, and then you start on G-sharp, you get this. And that's G-sharp Phrygian. There you go. Now, I've memorized the modes and the order that they go in and all that when you do the little C major thing by just using them a lot. But there's a couple of mnemonics that might help you, okay? I don't practice lousy modes a lot. Okay, that's one. Resolve that. I've developed perfectly logical modal associations. And then you have to remember Locrian. Because, I don't know, they just didn't have Locrian in that one. And then, I don't particularly like modes anyway. Especially Locrian, because that one also doesn't have Locrian in it. But my personal favorite, because I made this one, idiotic ducks parking luxurious McLarens and Lamborghinis. Resolve that. Okay, so there we go. We covered all of the goals, and now you know what the church modes are. The church modes are really important, and they're really useful. There's so much music theory that church modes open you up to, so it's good to know them. Thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed this or found it helpful, I'd love for you not to like. I mean, you can like the video, sure, but I'd love for you to check out my new album, which officially got released yesterday. It might be on Spotify when you're watching. If it's not on there today, it'll be on there tomorrow. And so if you want to listen to it on Spotify, And maybe if you like it a lot, buy it on iTunes or not. Go ahead, and I'll see you next video. Bye.